फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज कुलकर्णी सर विद यू टू इंटरेक्ट ऑन द टॉपिक दैट इज एरोमेटिक कार्बोक्सिलिक एंड सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड. मेनी ऑफ यू आर गाइस आर रिक्वेस्टेड टू मी टू मेक दिस वीडियो ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक, सो दैट्स व्हाई आई एम मेकिंग दिस वीडियो. फॉर द सेक ऑफ सिंपलिसिटी आई विल यूज ऑल दिस थ्री लैंग्वेज, दैट इज हिंदी, इंग्लिश एज वेल एज मराठी फॉर द ग्रास्पिंग ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक. सी फ्रेंड्स, let's begin with the topic, that is aromatic carboxylic and sulfonic acid. Name itself reveals that there is an compounds which containing with an aromatic ring. What is my carboxylic? Carboxylic, you know about that carboxylic is a functional group which is a COOH. What is my sulfonic? Sulfonic is a SO3H. This kind of functional group is introduced. So that's why this compounds are belong from this kind of functional group along with an aromatic ring. Okay, so there are two types of acids, that is aromatic carboxylic acids and aromatic sulfonic acids, that are studied under this topic of BSc second year semester 3. So let's begin. I will introduce first of all aromatic carboxylic acid. What are aromatic carboxylic acid? First point of our syllabus, that is an aromatic carboxylic acid. What is the definition of this compounds? Means aromatic carboxylic acid. What does it indicate? It indicates that on behalf of name, all the concepts are decoded here. So first of all, we have to know what is meant by aromatic. Aromatic, you know that the compound should must be planar, associated with an aromaticity. Compound should must be planar. It should have obeyed an Hooke's rule. It have a conjugated pi system electron above and below the plane, and each carbon should be sp2 hybridized. This kind of aromaticity criteria which are learned in our previous year standard, that is BSc first year. So these are said to be an aromatic compound. For example, if I take a benzene ring, it is also aromatic, which having directly associated with dash COOH as a functional group. The compounds which having a dash COOH functional group directly attached with an aromatic ring, such kind of compounds are said to be aromatic carboxylic acid. In short, we can write it as an AR stands for aromatic ring associated with an directly linked with COOH functional group. These are said to be aromatic acids. So what are the classification as well as these properties of these acids? We have to know that these compounds are generally, in previous year standard we have studied about that this benzoic acid or thalic acid, etc. Such kind of acids are used as a preservatives, additives. They are generally weak organic acids because hydrocarbon moiety is something less polar rather than the inorganic moiety. So that's why these are the generally weak acids which are used for making a different kind of buffers as well as in additives, preservatives, etc. Next one, these are purely crystalline compound. These are must be a crystalline compound. And readily soluble in water, but completely soluble in hot water as well as organic solvent like an ether, DMF, alcohol, etc. So that's why these are the some properties of this acids. Let's begin with the classification of that corresponding aromatic carboxylic acid. What is the classification of this aromatic carboxylic acid? The classification namely depends upon the number of COOH group directly associated with the aromatic ring. That is the aromatic ring. Okay friends, so let's begin with the classification. CLAWSIFICATION, this is the classification generally based on, that is dependent upon dash, number of dash COOH group, first category, that is monocarboxylic aromatic acid. The name itself decode all these things. What is the definition of this corresponding category? So mono stands for only one, carboxylic stands for COOH, aromatic acid means which contain an aromatic moiety, you know that. So on the definition we can plus or add it meet. What does it indicate? The aromatic acid which have only one COH group directly linked with an aromatic ring. Such kind of aromatic acids are said to be monocarboxylic aromatic acid. What is the definition, friends? I repeat, when only one COH group is directly linked with an aromatic ring, that is said to be monocarboxylic aromatic acid. This is enough. Next was, what are the examples associated with it? For example, if I take an example of aromatic ring, that is a benzene which contains with COH as a non-fluid. What is the name? This is a purely aromatic ring system. That's name is benzene. And what are the suffix for this acids? Only when it is a only one number of COH group, then it works as a prefix, sorry, suffix as an OIC acid. So name itself is that benzoic acid. Okay, friends. This is the name of this compound. If I take a next example, you know about that. In practical, you have seen this compound. This is a polyfunctional compound which contains an aromatic moiety with a COH as well as OH functional group. Okay. If I remove this OH, this will become a benzoic acid. If I remove this COH functional group, it will become a phenol. So that's why, according to the priority order which you have studied in previous year standards, so that's why numbering should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Because COH have a higher priority rather than OH. So OH will be works as a prefix. So that's why the IUPAC nomenclature of this compound. Instead of that, I will introduce this common name system, that is a salicylic acid. Salicylic acid is its common name. And this is the IUPAC name of this acid. What is the IUPAC name? The OH will work as a prefix, so that's why two position containing with an OH group. So 2-hydroxy only. What does it name? It names for the benzoic acid. So it will become 2-hydroxy benzoic acid. These are various kind of examples are introduced in this category, but I'll take this is a familiar. Okay. In practical, you will got this. Okay. Next. Next category, if I remove this mono, okay, so next category will move on. If I replace the prefix of this category, let me introduce another one, that is dicarboxylic aromatic acid. This is the second category. You know that, friends? So dash stands for 2. So what should be the definition of this category? The definition is such like that. When an aromatic acid which contains two COH as a functional group directly linked with an aromatic ring, that category of aromatic carboxylic acid is said to be a dicarboxylic aromatic acid. Let's begin with the example. For example, if I take such kind of aromatic compound that is benzene associated with C double bond of OH group and C double bond of OH group. You may have seen this compound in BSc first year practical, that is the conversion of thalic acid into the thalamide. You know, friends, so in this kind of condition we can use the funnel as well as glass wool. In this, H and OH will be removed by heating itself and the needle shaped crystals are obtained of thalic anhydride, that is this compound. Are you good, my friends? So this is your thalic acid and this is your thalic anhydride with the removal of water. Here we are hitting plus H2, water molecules are removed. This practical you may carry out in a basic first year. So this is the example of dicarboxylic aromatic acid, that is your thalic acid. Next, friends. So, what is the IUPAC name of thalic acid? In this compound, the nomenclature I will write here the spelling of thalic. Here the only P silent, not begins with a T. Okay, see here, this is spelling is a THALIC, thalic acid. What is the IUPAC name of this compound? And let's begin with the any one of this because both the group have a same priority. Then In clockwise or anti-clockwise, you may give as per your feasibility. So that's why I will make here clockwise 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. This is an benzene ring associated with a 2COH group. So what is the IUPAC name of this compound? In that category, it will work as a carboxylic acid as a suffix, not OIC acid. Okay, friends. So what does it indicate? Benzene. Benzene. 1,2 position containing a COH group. So benzene 1,2. Two times it will work as a prefix di. Benzene 1,2 di. What are the compound name itself? Suffix used as a carboxylic acid. So name itself says that benzene 1,2 di carboxylic acid. So friends, this is your first example. If I isomerize this compound in another way, there is a second example of this category. For example, if I isomerize this COH functional group from 2 position to 3 position, okay friends, from 2 position to 3 position, then if I replace this COH from 2 to 3, then this is said to be an isothalic acid. Iso, E-S-T-H-A-L-I-C, isothalic acid. This will give us as an isothalic acid. So what should be the name, that is the IUPAC name of this compound? It will exist with an aromatic moiety, that is benzene. So that's why benzene can't be replaced. It is only when position isomerism arises, when 1 and 3 position associated with an COH functional group. So that's why here I will replace only a 3. This is another example. So the IUPAC name of this compound will become a benzene 1,3 dicarboxylic acid. Next, if I introduce this COH from 3 position to 4 position, then this name becomes a terephthalic acid, T-E-R-E. So what is the changes occurring in this name? This is also the benzene moiety. If I number from here, this is also the 4 position and this is also the 4 position, because these are belong from the sigma, that is a planar symmetry. Okay, so benzene 1,3 associated with 1,4. So name of this compound will become so benzene 1,4 dicarboxylic acid. So these are the examples of dicarboxylic aromatic acid. Let's begin with the another ones, that is the next category of carboxylic acid, that is a, if I replace this with a tri, third category, this is a tricarboxylic aromatic acid. So what are the changes are needed to serve it? So definition itself will clearly reveal that when 3 COH functional groups are directly associated or directly linked with an aromatic ring, then such kind of category of aromatic acidic compounds are said to be an tricarboxylic aromatic acids. So let's begin with an example. If I take an benzene associated with an 3 COH group for such like that, this is the first kind of example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You know, you are familiar with the IUPAC nomenclature in previous standards, so that's why I am directly writing as a number, directly giving a numbering on to this compound. So 1, 2, 3, such like that. If I write here 1, 2, 3, this is also the right, because as per the lower frequency rule, it should be also obese and it should be also obese. So that's why, what is the name? This is a benzene. And COH works as a carboxylic acid because more than one COH are present in the group and having the same priority, so that's why the suffix of this COH will be become a carboxylic acid, not OIC acid. So that's why, what is the name? Name of this compound, it becomes a benzene 1,2,3. There is a 1,2,3, three positions associated with along with a continuous manner. 1,2,3, three times a means is coming here, tri. Tri stands for three times there is a presence of COH group. What are the suffix used for this COH? Carboxylic acid. CRBOXYWYC, carboxylic acid. See friends, this is the first example of tricarboxylic aromatic acid. If I isomerize this compound in a such a way that what should be done? If I replace this OH in such a manner, let me introduce another compound. That is, if I write here, then what is the numbering of this compound? If I introduce such like that, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. The numbering in rounded system is not incorrect because lowest look and root follows in such like condition, in anticlockwise, not in clockwise. If I introduce this function group will be a first ones, the numbering will be wrong because it will become so 1, 3, 4. So that's why this does not occur in lowest look and root. Instead of that, if I introduce such like that, if I introduce this carbon will become so 1, this will become 2, this will become 3, and this will become 4, then it will be a 1, 2, 4. So that's why 1, 2, 4. 1, 4 positions are fixed there. Instead of that, 2 position is nearest in anti-clockwise manner. So that's why this numbering should be a correct ones and instead of clockwise. So what is the IUPAC nomenclature of this compound? That is a benzene 1, 2, 4. This will be a wrong, which doesn't follow the lowest look and root. 1, 2, 4 tricarboxylic acid. So here we can write it and replace with a 1, 2, 4. Because here is a benzene, 1, 2, 4 is a correct numbering because it follows a lowest look and root. And tri stands for 3 COH group containing acids, and carboxylic acid works as a prefix. Sorry, suffix. Next example, if I introduce or replace this compound in another way, then that kind of acids, if I isomerize the same compound in such a way that here I introduce a COH, here I introduce a COH, and here I introduce a COH and then methanol, then what should be the name? In any direction you can give a name, in clockwise or anti-clockwise, you will get same priority, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, here 1, 3, 5, in any direction, you can try it, I will not try this because I know about that, you will try in any manner, you will get 1, 3, 5, as an lowest group and priority. So, what is the name? This is a benzene 1, 3, 5. Here only replace 1, 3, 5 tricarboxylic acid. These are the categories and classification of aromatic carboxylic acid. In the next video, we will try to explain all these things, that is a synthesis of our corresponding, that is a benzoic acid as well as the reactions. Thanks friends for watching. Keep it up, and your suggestions are more valuable for me. So give me the suggestions in comment section as well as let's begin with us. This is our first video, so I would like to tell that I will prefer all these languages in next video as well as for sake of simplicity. This is your first video. What should you think about that video? Please make me your comments in personally as well as my WhatsApp number. I will upload this video later if I check this and some critics or some corrections are there, then I will upload it sometime later. Thank you.